tell you what it's about.
Yeah.
Will and I had the, okay, Tonio K wrote that song. My dear friend Tonio K is one of my oldest friends.
Leave
the
head on. Leave
the head on. Leave the what? Take it out and put it down there. That's good. I'll take it out in a minute. But anyway, how about that? How about you? You didn't know you was coming to watch Hee Haw, did you? Anyway. Will you just let me finish? Jeez. So this friend of Will and I, he's another writer, and we know all these crazy, great writer people, Tonio not being one of them. But Will will get into something similar later, but he was at a party in Los Angeles, this writer, a friend of ours, he's a writer, anyway, like one of them. Stay on track, Charlie. So he's at this thing, and Bruce Springsteen is there. Right? And he tells this guy, like, yeah, Bruce Springsteen. There's a lot of people like that, they're kind of like, Springsteen, not really into him. And then they go to a show and they're like, I can't help it because it's great, you know. But, you know, it's easy to kind of go, man, I don't know about that guy. It shouldn't be easy. But anyway, so he's at this party and he's kind of got that thing, you know. And then he ends up sitting, you know, it's like a little small party and he ends up sitting on the couch with Bruce Springsteen, you know, and they're talking about this and that. And then,
just take it off.
I'm not toying with you, it's just actually just working out loud. He sits next to Bruce Springsteen on the couch, and Bruce goes, after a while he goes like, they don't care what I'm saying, they just want me to take the hat off. He sits down and he starts with friend David, and he goes, hey, you know, David, you know, life is like a car, or a boat, or a plane, to take you around the world, songs to take you around the world. And he thought, wow, this is cool. Like, Bruce is like getting heavy and philosophical with me, you know? And he knew it must be true because, you know, it's like his song's about a car. I mean, for years, like 30 years, Bruce just like driving around. You expect anywhere you go, you see him driving around. You know, well, I got on the highway in the city. You say true, I got my new Chevy in the road. So anyway, he was really, Bruce won him over. And he wasn't on poo-pooing Bruce, you know? He was like, hey, he's cool, man, that's nice. The next night, he goes to the Forum in Los Angeles, like the basketball and all that, right? Oh, yeah. And there's Bruce, and he's like, ah, that's cool, man. And Bruce comes up between songs, he's like, you know, songs are like a car, a plane, or boats. Even Bruce. Anyway, the whole point to my diatribe, thank you, Will. Will's favorite word for a year. Was that, it's that same story, you know. You see, like, I thought the guy was great. He told me just really, and then the next day, it's like the same. It's like, hey, man, you said I was a special one. Anyway, I'll go see you later. The reason I got into that was because I didn't tell the story about my dear friend, Mr. Tonio K. Who is a really, really, he's my soul brother in all those kind of ways. A soul brother can be a soul brother. Writing partner for years. He's got a hilarious website. Because he's a freak. But in a good, in a creative way. You know. I'm about out of time now after my yammering. TonioK.com. And he's a great writer, what have you. He wrote the song Impress, which is, I know that was like 2 months ago.
We like that song.
Thank you.
Okay. Oh yeah. Oh, I know
I would like to, I'm going to do this song. This is a song that was about when me and my brother moved to Austin, Texas. In 1972, roughly from San Antonio, Texas. And I'd like to do it in honor of my mother and my grandmother.
city, it's been good to see it. Me and my brother came from those two ladies, so I'm serious. I will take my hat off. The song was finished. I started it and finished it with my dear friend, which is also from San Antonio. His name is Mr. Steve Earle. There's a few people in the world that you can trust certain kinds of songs with. He's one of them. So it's called Dillingham Lane.
Stayed at home. When I got back, he walking around. And old Charlie lived in that one-room shack. He'd sit and stare out through his screen. And we'd wave to him, and he'd wave. Don't think I ever saw him leave. We both grew older. The wind blew colder. The only thing that's remained are footsteps down dead. So here we are, back home again. Another year's another street. And here and there are some homes to be, and promises to keep. As we all grow older, the wind blows colder. The only thing that still remains are footsteps. We grow older, wind blows colder. The only thing that still remains, the footsteps down Dillingham Lane.